This conference will now be recorded.
Methyl, which is having weak electron donating property, which is having weak electron donating property. Can be replaced by an electron donating can be replaced by an electron donating electron withdrawing group. Which will slow down the formation of aziridinium ion and increase the activity. Example, chlorambucil and melphalan. Even in cyclophosphamide, you have replaced the methyl group with that phosphamide group. Leave a line, next line. These drugs act by put point number one, damaging the DNA by inhibiting cross-linking of DNA strands. Next point, they prevent DNA synthesis and RNA transcription. If you recollect yesterday, I told you that there is DNA, then there is mRNA formation, and then there is protein formation from the mRNA. Okay, so it will not allow DNA synthesis also. It will not allow the transcription of RNA also to happen. So it prevents DNA synthesis and RNA transcription by attaching alkyl groups to DNA bases. Next point. By inducing mispairing of nucleotides, leading to mutation. Leave a line, put a star in the margin. Cyclophosphamide is a prodrug which requires metabolic activation. By cytochrome P450 enzyme, metabolic activation by cytochrome P450 enzyme in vivo converting it to the active form phosphoramide, converting it to an active form phosphoramide. Next line, again put star in margin. Chlorambucil. In vivo gets converted to chlorambucil. In vivo gets converted to phenylacetic acid. In vivo gets converted to phenylacetic acid. Which is the active alkylating agent? Which is the active alkylating agent? Okay. You have this synthesis in your syllabus. So please take it down. The synthesis of mechlorethamine. Let me know once you all are done. Okay. So these are two molecules of ethylene oxide. Okay, which are reacting with methylamine. So don't forget this two. So you don't have the synthesis in your syllabus, cyclophosphamide, chlorambucil. If you have the syllabus, you can check that you don't have them. Okay. Next, we move on to what are called as anti-metabolite agents. Okay. So metabolites again are your purine, pyrimidine bases. Okay, or purines and pyrimidines and your folic acid. Okay, so when you are growing, when you are developing your body, there are a lot of basic requirements that should be there. And the basic requirement for any DNA or RNA formation are your metabolites, that is your purines and pyrimidines and folic acids. Okay, if you recollect, during pregnancy, folic acid is strongly recommended. Lack of folic acid or not having enough of folic acid in the body of the pregnant woman can lead to the development of what is called as spina bifida in the fetus. Okay, So folic acid, purines and pyrimidines form the base of any structural development that is going to happen in your body. Okay. So these are your metabolites, purines, pyrimidine analogs and your folic acids. Now what they have done in designing this class of anti-cancer agents is they have developed anti-metabolites. So you have metabolites and you have something which are anti to it, which have an opposite structure or which are an allosteric structure or which will go and replace the actual purine, pyrimidine or folic acid in the synthesis process. And because of this replacement, you will not get a proper DNA or RNA structure. Okay. So these are what are anti-metabolites. So you have metabolites and you have something opposite working to like them, and they are called as anti-metabolites. Now all these metabolites, whether purine metabolites or whether pyrimidine metabolites, one thing that they have in common is they have to undergo the process of what is called as phosphorylation. Okay, that means phosphate groups have to get added for the drug to become active and go and sit into the site of activity. Okay, for example, here these are purine analogs which you can see, that is 6-mercaptopurine. Okay, so the name itself tells you that the structure is similar to purine. The mercapto group at the 6th position has been added to the purine to give you 6-mercapto. Now what will happen to this 6-mercaptopurine is this 6-mercaptopurine will undergo phosphorylation. So one phosphate group will be added, then again it will undergo phosphorylation, second phosphate group will be added, then it will undergo third phosphorylation, and the third phosphor group will be added to it, and after that it becomes a active 6-mercaptopurine or phosphorylated 6-mercaptopurine. Okay, so once this 6-mercaptopurine undergoes phosphorylation 3 times, you get the activated drug, which will then go and take its place in the purine, which wherever purine is there in the DNA double helical structure, and it will disrupt the DNA double helical structure. It will not allow the nucleotides to become replicate, or the cell will not replicate, and therefore there will be cell growth inhibition because of replacement of a wrong purine. Okay, so this is like you have something which looks alike but is the villain for the cell growth. Okay, so purine is something your cell needs. 6-mercaptopurine is something which is going to harm the cell. So this 6-mercaptopurine becomes the villain. It will go and replace in the purine, and it will disrupt the normal cycle of what was supposed to happen. Okay, so take down anti-metabolites. Anti-metabolites are compounds which inhibit or prevent which inhibit or prevent biosynthesis of normal cellular metabolites. Biosynthesis of normal cellular metabolites. Their chemical structure is closely similar. Their chemical structure is closely similar to natural metabolites. To natural metabolites. Antimetabolites can be of three types. Antimetabolites can be of three types. Purine analogs, PURINE, ANA, LOGUES. Purine analogs, pyrimidine analogs, third, folic acid analogs. Third, folic acid analogs. First is purine analogs. Write little quickly. Example, 6-mercaptopurine and azathioprine. You can take down both the structures. You take down the structure of 6-mercaptopurine and azathioprine. Only two structures. Take down. The structure of these drugs is similar to hypoxanthine and guanine. Is similar to hypoxanthine and guanine. These analogs, have a sulfahydryl, or thiol group. At the sixth position, of the purine ring instead of oxygen. Okay, you can see here the structure of 6-mercaptopurine at this position where I am pointing out, where you can see the S. Usually there is an oxygen. Okay, when you are having the normal purine structure. Now that normal oxygen has been replaced by sulfur or S over here. Or here it has been replaced by a bulky group which is having as a and thio, that is nitrogens as well as sulfur. It is replaced by a bulky group in the case of as a thioprene. Next line, take down. These purine analogs need to undergo phosphorylation to be activated. Need to undergo phosphorylation to be activated. Next line, in vivo 6-mercaptopurine is converted to its corresponding ribonucleotide which is 6-methyl thio-inosinate, which is an enzyme inhibitor. This gets incorporated in the place of guanine. During the formation of DNA and RNA. Next, leave a line. Next line. As a thioprene. Slowly gets converted to 6-mercaptopurine by a series of non-enzymatic reactions. It antagonizes the purine metabolism. Inhibits the synthesis of DNA, RNA, and proteins. And interferes with cellular metabolism and mitosis. Cellular met- mechanism and mitosis. So this was the mechanism of action of both 6-mercaptopurine as well as azathioprine. Okay, next is pyrimidine analogs. Pyrimidine analogs. Example 5-fluorouracil. Okay, so this is the uracil structure minus the fluorine. This is the uracil. In the proper uracil structure, this fluorine is not there. But when you introduce this fluorine at the 5th position in the uracil structure, you get 5-uracil. Okay, so take down the structure of 5-fluorouracil. Pyrimidine analogs are compounds which inhibit the action of enzyme thymidylate synthetase, thymidylate, thymidylate synthetase, synthetase, which is responsible for converting. These are all very important points. Okay, so underline the word thymidylate synthetase enzyme, which is responsible for converting 2-deoxyuridylic acid to thymidylic acid for DNA synthesis. Thus inhibiting synthesis of DNA. Next, leave a line. Next line. 5-fluorouracil is designed a conversion of to block the conversion of uridine to thymidine. It is obtained by replacing the hydrogen atom. At the fifth position in the uracil structure. With fluorine atom. Next line, in vivo, 5-fluorouracil will be converted to its deoxyribose monophosphate metabolite. Which will result in the formation of, thymidylate formation and inhibition of DNA and RNA synthesis and eventually cell death Okay, now in this antimetabolite, we have the next class, which is called as the folic acid analogs. Okay, so like I told you, folic acid is very important for you or for any growth to happen. Okay, so the example for folic acid analog is methotrexate. Quickly take down the structure so that I can finish this class today. Quickly take down the structure of methotrexate, which is a folic acid analog. Now, folic acid exists as dihydrofolate and tetrahydrofolate, and this tetrahydrofolate is important for the synthesis of purines and thymidines. Okay, so the very basic thing that you require, purine, pyrimidine or thymidine, these different bases is supported by the presence of tetrahydrofolic acid and dihydrofolic acid. So if you don't have dihydrofolic acid and tetrahydrofolic acid, your purines and pyrimidines only will not be formed. So if purines and pyrimidines are not formed, then the further question, you know, does not arise of any DNA RNA multiplication. Okay, so this is like, it is hitting the basic foundation of cell development. Okay, it is hitting the basic foundation of cell development where it is not allowing the conversion of dihydrofolic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid. And if this folic acid is not converted to tetrahydrofolic acid, purines and pyrimidines will not be formed. Okay, so I assume you have taken down the structure of methotrexate. Take down. Folic acid reduced to tetrahydrofolic acid, THF, into bracket you can write all three capital THF. Folic acid gets reduced to tetrahydrofolic acid, which is necessary for the synthesis of purines, thymidine, and some amino acids. Pyridines, thymidine, and some amino acid. Leave a line. Folic acid analogs. Folic acid analogs competitively inhibit the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase. Folic acid analogs competitively inhibit the enzyme dihydrofolate, preventing the synthesis of THF, thus preventing the synthesis of THF. The presence of basic group, the presence of basic groups sorry the presence of amino groups the presence of amino groups increases the basicity of methotrexate increases the basicity of methotrexate and increases the affinity to the enzyme okay, if you see this methotrexate structure here, you see that NH2 over here, I'm pointing it out with the computer this, and another one is over here. Okay, so both of them are the amino groups that are attached into the folic acid into the methotrexate structure. If you compare this methotrexate tetrahydrofolic acid structure, you will see that this amino group below one, this amino group which I am pointing out with the cursor is not there. Here there is a double bond which is present in the tetrahydrofolic acid structure, and here also there is the amine group. Okay, so because of replacement of the entire basis double bond O with an amino group, density of the compound increases and its affinity to the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase increases. It will inhibit the action of dihydrofolate reductase enzyme. It will not let the conversion of folic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid to happen. And if tetrahydrofolic acid is not formed, then there will be no formation of purines and thymidines. Okay, so these are the three analogs, metabolic analogs, that is purine analogs, pyrimidine analogs, and folic acid analogs. So we have seen a few examples from all of them, azathioprine and mercaptopurine and purine analogs, and we have seen 5-fluorouracil in pyrimidine analogs, and in the case of folic acid analogs we have seen methotrexate. Now in your syllabus there are more drugs which come into this class, so whatever drugs that I have left out on purpose, it is your duty to find out the structure from the textbooks and make notes of those drugs. Notes as in you need to tell the mechanism of action, the structure and use Okay, if you see, I have not given you uses of any of the drugs, because you can do that on your own by opening pharmacology books. You can party. I have concentrated on the chemistry and SAR of all these compounds. Okay, whether it is an antihistaminic chapter or whether it is this topic, you are specifying uses of all the drugs so that you can write them in the exams as well. Okay. So with this, we finish antimetabolites. The next class is that of metal complexes. We will start this in the next class. I'll tell you when the next class is. I will drop a message to one of you all from your class, either the CR or somebody, one of you all. I will tell you all when is the class. We may not be using GoToMeeting from 1st of July. I don't know. If it is getting renewed, if it gets renewed, we will use GoToMeeting or we will shift to. Okay, so you be prepared to download the Zoom app once again and use it for class purpose. Okay, is it clear? If you have any difficulties, you can ask me in the next class, or you can ask me in the next class. That's better. Is it clear? Shall we stop there? It's 9. Yes. Okay. Yes, you all can leave. Okay, thank you.